on behalf of him. So before our presentation, I would like to introduce you the Dr. Samakyong. Dr. Samakyong is a president of the Singapore Institute of Engineering Technologies. His academy is a resident. He received his basic engineering knowledge at the University of Melbourne and did his postgraduate studies in engineering at the National University of Singapore and the Nanyang Technological University in Singapore. He also completed the medical professional qualifications. The certification qualifications are a chartered engineer, UK in a civil engineering discipline, materials production, chartered engineer Ireland, chartered professional engineer Australia, registered engineer Papua New Guinea, chartered surveyor UK, chartered construction manager UK, chartered building engineer UK, chartered environmentalist UK, chartered mathematician UK, and chartered scientist UK, and chartered qualities of professional UK. Those are the most significant achievement of the Mr. Sam's of engineer's career. So Mr. Sam is very interested in the engineering education system throughout his life. He is founded the Singapore Institute of Engineering Technologies. He is one of the founder member, and also he would like to contribute his professional skill for the Myanmar engineering development. So I start to present his about presentation. So the outline of the presentation includes the introduction and general criteria, England, the CM Charter Engineer Standard, and the Singapore's professional engineer B requirements, and the sign useful links. Those are the major categories included in the presentation. So before I make the presentation, I would like to go through the technical achievement of the engineering profession. Golden Gate Bridge is founded in the 1933 to 1937. It's one of the very excellent engineering examples in the United States of America. So this is the issue that is a diagram you can see from the information from the Golden Gate. And those engineers who submitted the Golden Gate Bridge is a great engineer in the century. Similarly, this is not the history of the war at the Golden Gate is in the United States, and also the South is history. The Sydney Harbour Bridge is also one of the very big achievement of the engineering. So Sydney Harbour Bridge was construction began in 1923 and then completed in 1932. So as you see in this diagram, this is about the bridge. Figure on the Sydney Harbour Bridge. So the detailed technical information are the Sydney Harbour Bridge and the 8 roadways, 2 rail tracks, 1 pedestrian way and 1 cycle way. They are the bridges that go started to cross the Port Jackson in the Sydney Harbour and also located in the Sydney, Australia. And the design is a through the Arch Bridge. And the total length is 1.49 meter or 3770 feet. And the width is 49 meter, and height is 132 meter, and longest way is 5.3 meter, and clearance below is 49 meter. Construction begin at the 28 July 1923, and the construction ended at the 19 January 1932. Opened in the 90s, and 19 March 1992. So 1932. So this is for some technical details on the Sydney Harbour Bridge. So finally, I present the. This information is, those are the examples of the big engineering achievement on the wall. So this is the details of construction, some plan of the fine, how the engineers, Sydney Harbour Bridge, constructors, and near the 100-year goals. So then, those are the construction diagram you can see on here. And similarly, not only are engineering achievements are not only limited to the industrial country. In Asia, in ASEAN country, the Sultan Abdul Halim's Madzam's Shah Bridge. This is in the Penang. So this is the second bridge of the Penang. It's located in Malaysia. This is one of the very big achievement in the ASEAN engineering profession. So those are the examples of the ASEAN engineer who constructed the very significant and very excellent construction work. How they can do it? Because they are very trained, they are very confident. Technically, professionally, academically, they learned a lot and they got a very experienced engineer and a great engineers. Therefore, that they can wear the design, the very significant and very excellent achievement of the walls of engineering examples. So this is what I'm giving information about the Sudan Abdul Hassan and Madrasan Shahbazi. Okay, so this is engineering very achievement. So that this the new generation of engineer need to be competent because of the engineering areas are developing the profession. So more and more new generation need to have the more competency. Therefore, the living standard and the development of the whole world and can be made and can be improved. So engineer registrations are a very important aspect to maintain the competency of the engineer. So then, now I'm talking about the why register. What is a competence? What is a commitment and regulation standards? Those are the important aspects in engineering registration. Why the people need to register as an engineer? What is the meaning of the competence? What is the commitment of the engineer to work in the host country and the host communities? And also the registration standards, how the industry is regulated by means of the registration standards, those will be explained. Why register? The reason to register is to ensure the current and the future safeguarding the society. So safeguarding the society is a very important aspect because of the engineer, the ethics, engineer competency are for the safeguarding the society. And a commitment to the professional standards. So the professional standards are the governing the whole professional. So that all the professional people have to follow the professional standards. So they must have a commitment to professional standards. Commitment to the continuing professional development, CBD. Because the technical is ever changing, voice is ever changing. Therefore, the competency standard need to be maintained. So the engineer cannot stop at the one step. They have to be ever in need to improve the competency standard. And then they are need to be covered by the professional code of the conduct. So professional code of conduct is a very important aspect of the engineering profession. What is a competent? The definition of competent is the ability to carry out a task to an effective standard. So the engineer must have the ability to carry out a task to an effective standard. So the standard needs to be developed by the relevant engineering professional bodies. The engineer must have the right level of knowledge, understanding, skill, and a professional attitude. Therefore, there are many fields of engineering, electrical, mechanical, civil, electronic, mining, and chemical. Those engineers must have an appropriate level of knowledge in their job. They need to understand the engineering fundamental as well as a technical approach. They must have the skill to do the tasks, and they must have the professional attitude to provide the safeguarding and a safe environment of the living standards for the whole communities. So they need to also maintain the professional attitude. They need to maintain their way to sustain the whole environment requirements, the whole environment aspects. What is a commitment? The meaning of a commitment is a personal and a professional commitment to the society, their professional and the environment. A set of values and behaviors that we maintain and enhance the reputation of the profession. So the professional engineer need to must have a commitment to seek the benefit of the society and safety of the society, and as well as they are professional and also the environment. Environment is a very important aspect. When the environmental disaster happens, it will be very negative impact and a very impact to the whole country and the whole nation. So the action of the engineer need to be ever concerned with how their action can advance the impact on the environment. So this is the environmental concern is very important for the engineer. Several behavior, engineer must have the behavior, honesty, maintaining, and enhance the reputation of the profession. Because why engineer do the improbable, all the engineering workforce reputation can be undermined. And in the view of the public views, and their whole profession again, these are devalued. So that engineers need to maintain their values and their behaviors, so that the whole reputation of the profession can be regarded and can be promoted. So that now I follow talking about the registry standard. So registry standards of England. So England is a very old professional. Most of the engineering institution has been founded by the England, and the many countries follow the English standards. So that in the United Kingdom, so that there are three categories of the engineer: engineering technician, incorporated engineer, and a chartered engineer. Engineering technicians are the technical people, incorporated engineers are the field engineer and predicate engineer, and the charter engineers are the engineers who are responsible for the designing, the building, the engineering projects, and who are making the innovation in the engineering profession. So there are three categories of engineers. Those engineers are registered by the England Engineering Council, United Kingdom Engineering Council. So they are registered standards. So similarly in the Asia, they are the standard of the Singapore engineers. In the Singapore, there are four classes of the engineering profession: professional engineer B, registered resident engineer RE, registered technical officer RTO, licensed electrical engineer, licensed electrical technician, and licensed electrician. Those are the Singapore engineering profession. Professional engineers are very similar to the level of the PE in Myanmar. Registered resident engineers are RE, so that RSE, so we also, Myanmar also has a relevant profession. Registered technical officers are similar to those who hold the engineering diploma and who are working as an engineering technician in a work site. And licensed electrical engineer, licensed electrical technician, licensed electrician, those are three staff qualifies as engineer. So they are skills and workers and three qualifies as engineer. So there are the four classification of the engineering profession in Singapore. So every classification, they have a specific rule and a regulation. So then, secondly, I'm talking about the general criteria for the registration. So for the England system, there are five general areas of the competence and commitment. So the Society of Professional Engineers of the UK, they set up the five general areas of competence and commitment. A, knowledge and understanding. The engineer must have the engineering knowledge and understanding the engineering fundamental principle and application, and design and the deployment of processes, services and products. So the engineer must have the competency in making the engineering design and deployment of the production and processes, and the engineering system, and providing the engineering service and the production of the engineering products. They have the second area of the knowledge. And engineer must also have the responsibility. Responsibility, management of the leadership. So the responsibility means the engineer is responsible for the whole project. PE are the responsible for the whole project. And as not only the materials aspect, but also the managing the engineering workforce to provide the good quality output of the engineering tasks and function. And engineers also need to communicate. They need to communicate with their peers, and their workers, and their advisors, and their subordinates, and also the general public. So they must have the appropriate communication and the interpersonal skills, and also the professional commitment. Professional commitment means that the engineer must have the commitment to safeguard the public safety, and to safeguard the environment, and to maintain the sustainability of the engineering function. So that all five factors are general area of the commitments and the commitments and the commitments for the engineering profession. So the specific evidence, commitment is required in a foreign area of complying with the codes of the quotas. So engineering profession is governed by the code of the quotas. So the engineer from PE is a code of quotas. Engineering ISC code of quotas. Those are set up by the national body who govern the profession. So engineers need to comply with the code of quotas. They need to follow and obey the relevant rule and the regulation and the law of the engineering profession. Managing and applying the safe system on the wall. A safety is a fast because of the worker injury on the workplace injuries are undesirable. All the engineering work, all the standard, all the equipment, tools and materials must be the safeguard the same. And undertaking the engineering activities in a way that contribute to the sustainable development. Sustainable development is that they need to concern about the environment that are impact of caused by the engineering activity, so that not only are the technical completion, they also have the responsibility to concern about the environment that are impact. So undertaking the engineering activities in a way that contributes to sustainable development. So that to maintain the professional competency, engineers need to follow the required continuing professional development, CPD. Carrying out the CBD necessary to maintain and enhance their competence. So that actively participating within the profession. So once you engineer are classified as a PE or ISE, they need to be in the profession. They need to actively participating within the profession. So those are the commitments. So goals for DASA, points are the point related to the commitment of the engineers. So that then I'll be talking about the United Kingdom Charter Engineer Standard. Who are the Charter Engineers? What are their responsibility? So the Charter Engineers are categorized by their ability to develop the appropriate solution to engineering problems using the new or the existing technologies through the innovation, creativity, and change. So those are basis of capability and ability of the Charter Engineers. They must have the ability to develop the appropriate solution to the engineering problem. They have to use a new or the existing technology through the innovation, creativity, and change. So the Society of Professional Engineers, UK SPEC, is a UK standard for the professional engineering competence. So the UK standard for the professional engineering competence are UK SPEC. So therefore, UK SPEC are the also the SATA. SATA is a standard and a route to the registration. They are developed by the England's Engineering Council in 1984. They are amended and updated in 1990 and 1997. So here is a website to view the document related to the SATA. So SATA is the engineering regulation standards and developed by the United Kingdom Engineering Council. So the academic requirement for those seeking the CN registration are UK qualification. The applicants who started their UK study after the 1st December 1999 will need the following exemplars qualification or the equivalent. The qualification will be the accredited bachelor degree with the honors in engineering or technology plus appropriate accredited master degree or appropriate further learning to master level or the accredited integrated master of engineering degree. So those are the educational requirement of the CM or Charter Engineer. So the applicants who started their study before the 31st August 1999 will need an accredited bachelor degree with the honors in engineering or equivalent. So those are academic requirements of the CN registration. So they are CN courses usually the state one engineers are who certify the academic standard. State two is who fulfill the completed training requirement, and state three is a fully fledged charter. So there are three kind of the classification in the UK system. So the basic borders are academic standard requirement for the CN State 1 registration. So the UK SPEC CN standard is that there are five main elements. It is an engineering knowledge understanding. So this is like A1 and A2. So engineering application P1, P2, P3, and management and leadership C1, C2, C3, C4. inter personal scale diwan dilu trine yang obligation to the society the professional and environment iwan itu idri ibu to are the five and main elements of the CSR standard. So engineering knowledge is a similar to the engineering fundamental. So now Myanmar engineering council order the engineering fundamental. Engineering application is similar to the engineering practice. And manager and leadership, so this is for the engineering master management leadership skill. Interpersonal skill is also the communication and capability. And obligation to the society, professional environment is also is a belong to the engineering ethics. So there are five areas of this element. For requirement for the CNs standard, UK standard. And so I further explain about the engineering knowledge and understanding. So AI is a maintaining the extended sound field to get approach and enabling the introduction and exploration of new and advancing technology and other relevant and developments. So charter engineer must have the sound field to get knowledge. So field to get knowledge is an important aspect and also the new and advancing technology and other relevant and development. A2s are engaged in the creativeness of an innovative development of engineering technology and continuous improvement system. This means the charter engineer are able to engage and create and innovate the development of engineering technology. New technologies are being developed, so the charter engineer has responsibility to engage and develop the new technology and also the continuous improvement. So both are the engineering knowledge and understanding. And engineering application, D1 is identify the potential project opportunities. So they need to identify which projects are required to develop and offer engineering opportunities are need to be identified and coordinate the appropriate research and undertake the design and development of the engineering solution. So charter engineer need to do the engineering research work and appropriate design and development tasks and the engineering solution need to be developed by them. B3 is implement the design solution and evaluate their effectiveness. Not only is implementing the design solution, they also have to evaluate their effectiveness. Whether they require some problem fully resolved or not, though they have to be evaluated. So they must have the appropriate evaluation capability in the engineering application. So those are in very first regarding the engineering application. And management and leadership. Management and leadership is also important because the engineers are leading the workers in the engineering project tasks. So the project implementation, they must have the appropriate implementation and capability. They need to manage the function, plan, budget, organize, direct and control task, people and resources. Those are the management function, engineering management function. And not only are the materials and technical management, they also are managing the people. So human resource and management, HRM, they need to lead the teams and develop the staff to meet the changing technical and the managerial needs. So the charter engineers are the leaders of the engineering profession. They are leading the engineering teams, they are developing the staff, so they're developing the staff capability, guiding the staff to meet the changing technical and managerial needs. And quality management. Quality management also the important aspect. Charter engineers are responsible for the maintaining the quality of their engineering production and their products and their service. Interpersonal skill. Interpersonal skill is also related to their communication capability. They must have a written communication. They must have the ways of prepared report, minutes and letters. They have to communicate with their subordinate, their advisor, their supervisor and public. They must have the appropriate capability in a written communication. Oral communication and presentation are also important. Before the projects are in design work, they need to present their design work and they need to answer the question of the public or the other engineers, professionals, associates, and also they need to communicate with their supervisor. And personal and social skills are also important aspects. Group threes are fatal. D1, D2, D3 are the interpersonal skills, requirement for the charter engineer. Obligation to the society and the profession and the environment. In this case, engineer must regard the society and must safeguard the safety of the society. So the code of conduct and the professional conduct is a very important aspect. They need to honestly perform their duty and responsibility. They need to honestly present the advantage and disadvantage regarding the proposed engineering project. They cannot hide the facts. They cannot hide the facts, and they cannot misuse their authority. They must safeguard the welfare of their subordinates, also the safeguarding the public safety. Safety is also an important aspect, so site safety, industrial safety, occupational health safety, rule and regulation need to be regarded, and they need to provide the appropriate safe working environment for their workers. Sustainable development is also an important aspect because of the sustainability of the engineering and profession, sustainability of the project work, sustainability of the constructed and completed tasks, and also the sustainable approach to the preserving the natural resources. Those things are important aspects, and CBD, so that to maintain their professional competency, the charter engineer need to maintain this CBD activity, need to take part in the CBD. CBD means attending the courses, reading the engineering textbook, participating in the engineering workshop, or the providing research. Who are the CBDs that either formal or informally? They need to fulfill the certain CBDs criteria within their registrations of media. So those are to admit as a charter engineer, and the people who apply for the CM need to enter the professional review. So professional review is conducted by their registration authority. So they find a professional review. So professional review is a member of the IC is the Institution of the Civil Engineering UK. The professional review is a made up of the following steps. Production and submission of the report. So this is the engineering report. So then in the reports of the engineer need to write about the specific report and specifications of design work and project work. They have to write down about the report. And after that, based on the assessing the reports, they have to enter the interview. An interview where you will be required to demonstrate how you can certify the specific attributes relevant to the grade you are applying for. So this is all the grades that were previously I talking about, the A to the E. Those are the competency elements standard. Those need to be demonstrated by the engineer who apply for the CM. And writings is a sign. Writing is a sign that with the exception of technical professional review, they also have to provide with their written is a sign. So in this case, the technical interview review panel, we ask the engineer to write on the subject topics, and that's all. Then the topic may be either engineering topics or the management topics. So engineer need to write about this technical aspect, also the professional aspect, although they need to highlight the important aspect of the engineering elements, competency element, though they need to be demonstrated by the writing. So those written is, as I said, can also be provided in the technical interview. So this is for the IC headquarter from the England standard. So the Charter Engineer CNMIC is a member of the Institution of the Civil Engineer. There will be people have to follow other three steps. First step is a knowledge base, and this means that academic qualification. So the academically must have the accredited master of engineering in UK or the equivalent. So this is for the academic requirement for the state ones are standard. State two is an initial professional diplomas IPD. So after the graduation, the engineer must follow the professional diploma activities. And then after that, they fulfill the starting standard of the professional competency, and they have achieved the starting superior, starting work experience, and then they have to enter the professional review. So professional review is CBR. So this is the professional review process. And after professional reviews, we include the interview, writing, the demonstration, those aspects have to be passed through. After that, the CNMIC will be granted. So this is for the are both examined on the rule of the ICE, so they are rule and professional examination. ICE also wanted the professional examination, so the rule for the professional examination standard, so to our textbook. And for the follow-up writing, so the how to pass a professional examination, principle for the Institute of Civil Engineering, they are the resources published by the Institution of Civil Engineering. And also the initial professional development, successful professional review, those are guidelines are also provided by the publication. So this is what I'm talking about the in-class standard. Because of the Myanmar citizens are also the base, a lot of some Myanmar engineering professions are far the in-class standard. So the, I'm talking about the in-class CN standard. And then we're talking about the Singapore. The Singapore's professional PE requirement, I will follow up explain more. In the Singapore, the best way to become a professional engineer in Singapore is the first reason the applicant must have the appropriate qualification. For example, a Bachelor of Engineering from the NUS or NU, National University of Singapore, or the Nanyang Technological University. And after that, fundamental engineering is PEB. So PEB is a professional engineer book of the Singapore. So the engineer must sit the FEA, the FEA is a fundamental engineering examination. And after that, the engineer must acquire the relevant experience, the relevant duration of the experience. After that, professional engineer book PE exam. So this is the professional engineer or engineering practice exam they have to sit for. So that the summary of the postgraduate professional experience and report and on the postgraduate engineering experience. So they also must complete it. And after that, the engineer must sit the professional interview. So that upon the successful completion of the professional interview PI, the professional engineer PE will be granted by the PEB, a professional engineer board of the Singapore. So the professional engineer registration examination, so there are two aspects, so two components. Professional engineer book Singapore, that is the professional engineer registration examination. So it's included two major components. The first is the fundamental engineering examination, and second part is the practice of professional engineering examination. So that in my slide, I also provide the example of the fundamental engineering examination and the practice of the professional engineering examination. Rather, I will show you the resources. So the resources example. So that every examination are lower the area of every examination. Then every examination is included in the Annex A. The format and the syllabus reading this and the question from the past year paper. So they include the other resources. So the resources include the fundamental engineering examination syllabus, recommended reading this question from the past year paper, fundamental engineering examination electrical, recommended reading this electrical question from the past year paper electrical, fundamental engineering examination mechanical question from the past year paper mechanical. Those are the included. So those are resources regarding the FE examination. So PEB, Professional Engineering Board of the Singapore, they publish the fundamental information regarding the FE examination. So those are useful links. Useful links of this are United Indian Engineering Council, Institute of Engineering, Institute of Engineering and Technology. So before that, the Institute of Engineering and Technology is a previous IEE. IEE is an institution of the electrical engineer. And after this, the IEE combined with the incorporated engineer, and then they form a new institution, the margin the sovereign institution, so they now are Institution of Engineering and Technology. Also the Institution of Mechanical Engineer, Charter Institute of Building, and Charter Association of the Building Engineer, those are the engineering professional registered institution. Those institutions are authorized by the UK Engineering Council to assess the engineer. So engineer need to be apply for the membership of the those engineering institution, and then up on the completion of the appropriate professional assessment, the institution normally the engineers will be registered as a charter engineer with the UK Engineering Council. And for the Singapore Institutional Engineer Singapore is the institution that's govern the that's included more than Singaporean engineers. Not only the Singaporean but also the overseas engineer. They are engineering professional association of the all engineers in Singapore. It's an institution of the engineer Singapore. And since you in the city you call engineering technologies, this is for the SIED. SIED is the engineering technology, technical engineer, site engineer, they are SIED. And professional engineer board of Singapore is from BEPO. So this issue the engineers are licensing and registration in Singapore. So this is for the information. So thank you for your attention and any questions. So that you can ask me the question, and but those are PowerPoint slides are not prepared by me. So I present on behalf of the Dr. Samangao, so that all your questions I will note it, and I send the email to him, and then his reply will be shared to you. So that Dr. Samangao also send you the message. That's what you do. Believe in your intentions, and you will be the better. You better be able to pick yourself up and brush yourself off the everyday. Five lives are not always fair. It is a manageable. It's a matter of attitude and confidence. So this is for the message from the customer. So there are many things in life that we catch your eye, not only in the few we catch your heart and passion grows. So this is a passion. So passion by the Singaporean engineer toward the German engineer. So creating from the Singapore Institute of Engineering Technologies.
ဟုတ်ကဲ့ရပါပြီအရောင်းစေတုံးနဲ့အင်္ဂလန်နဲ့ဆိုင်တဲ့ဟောဒီ assessment စာနေလည်းဖြစ်ပါတယ်အဲ့တော့ဒီကပတ်သက်တဲ့ရွှေချက်ကြီးကျွန်တော်နောက်ပြင်ကြပါမယ်အခုကမ္ဘာခြားရရှက်ပြီးတော့ပြင်ကြပါမယ်အကြောင်းအရာကိုရှင်းပါတယ်ဒါကပါလဲဆိုရင်ကမ္ဘာဆမ်မန်ကောင်းကတဲ့ကိုသားကျွန်တော်ကစင်ကာပူနဲ့အင်္ဂလန်နဲ့ဖိလစ်ပင်ကြောက်ပြင်ကြပါမယ်